Good afternoon. Thanks everybody for joining us. We're here for our series Working AI, and today we're talking about how to secure Work AI and Glean's approach to infrastructure and data privacy. I'm sitting down with Sunil. Sunil, can you go ahead and introduce yourself?
Thanks, Julie. Glad to be here. Sunil Agrawal, the CISO at Glean. I joined about 2 years back, and actually I had the privilege of being a Glean customer before I joined Glean. So I knew everything about Glean, the security of Glean. I was so impressed that I decided to come and join the company. So here I am.
Well, we're glad to have you on the other side and as a former customer as well. One of the keys to unlocking kind of Work AI is enterprise data. And there are inherent security, compliance, and privacy concerns as you deal with enterprise data. How did Glean design its infrastructure with that type of data privacy in mind?
Glean knew that because of the kind of data that we're dealing with, customer would want the highest level of security. So we started with being a single-tenant solution. When the world was going multi-tenant, every SaaS provider provides multi-tenant. We went single-tenant. Every customer gets their own GCP project, their own AWS account. All the data always stays within that GCP project or AWS account. They have complete control. Those are some of the very fundamental things that we built right from the get-go.
Glean takes a horizontal approach to Work AI. So it has hundreds of different connectors, and each of those applications has different levels of data access for different users. How does Glean ensure that it's giving the right level of data access to each of the users?
So this is, again, one of those fundamental pillars that Glean was built upon. When you connect Glean to any of your data sources, we not only crawl and index in all the data that's present there, at the same time, we also crawl all the identity and the permission associated with each one of them. Then, through mechanisms like webhook and incremental crawl, we stay in sync with any of the changes that might happen, either to the content or to the permissions in the data sources. So in near real time, we sync all that information. Now, when the user is searching for any information in Glean, the entire stack is permission aware. We make sure that the user gets access to only the information that they have access to in the source system. And our entire integration is native. If you're familiar with Google Drive, in addition to specifying who can access, you can also specify that, hey, only show up this data if the user has a link. Do not show up in search, or allow this data to be searched. So we understand that level of permission and we enforce that within Glean.
Many companies achieve security through obscurity. And they haven't put into place the right permissioning or the right retentions policies to ensure that their data is secure. As Glean onboards customers, how does it help to deal with this issue of security through obscurity?
This is one of those things that, you know, many of our customers face. Many of our customers, what they do is they first connect all the data sources to Glean. They only roll it out to a small cohort of people, you know, be their security team, their privacy team, or the compliance team. Glean has this functionality called sensitive content report. We look for all the places where the sensitive content might be present, show that in a report, and for each of those findings, we provide a lot of rich context. We just don't tell you that we found the salary information or we found SSN. We tell you, where did we find it? Who authored the document? What was the role of that person? Which department do they belong to? How many people it has been shared with? How many times has it been viewed? We provide rich set of findings and we support over 100 data types. They are built on many machine learning models because we are able to detect names, addresses, and many other complex data types. Many of our customers have used this functionality to actually improve the security posture before they feel comfortable rolling out Glean to the rest of the employee base.
Generative AI has brought about a lot of new security concerns, and one of those is around LLMs, or large language models, and making sure that there's no data leakage. How does Glean make sure that permissions are enforced with LLMs?
LLMs, you know, they're great technology, but one thing they do not understand is permissions. Once you put data in there, you know, they will spit it out, you know, when you ask a question. The key to making sure that you are using LLM in the safest possible way for your enterprise is you got to do permission enforcement external to the LLMs. Glean through its unique RAG architecture, we make sure that whenever you do ask Glean a question, we will use our underlying search system, which is absolutely permission enforced. We fetch those snippets of documents that you have access to. And it's only those snippets get fed into LLM to create a cohesive answer. The information that goes in is permission enforced. That's how the entire system remains permission enforced.
There's also some partnerships that we've done with LLM providers to keep this data secure and make sure that, you know, if one user puts it in, doesn't remember that session.
When we partner with the Azure OpenAIs and the Geminis of the world, we make sure that all the data that's fed into LLM that will be used only to answer the query. They cannot persist that data on disk. They cannot use the data for training any other model. The technical measures we have done and the contractual agreements that we have with the LLM providers ensures that the enterprise data remains secure at all times.
As generative AI continues to have huge waves of innovation, I assume that's also going to impact Glean's security framework. How are you seeing Glean be agile in developing its security for Gen AI?
First of all, you were born in the cloud, born during the remote work. So there were certain security fundamentals that we adopted from day zero. Things like zero trust, we just had to adopt it because everyone was remote when we started. Every single access is authenticated, authorized, and audit logged. When we talk about authentication, we started on day zero with MFA. When we talk authorization, we practice the principles of least privilege. Before just-in-time was a hot buzzword, we adopted it. A huge credit to the founders of the company. They had the right security mindset from day zero, and whenever technologies were missing, we created those technologies for our internal consumption. And we plan to continue on that journey as we adopt more Gen AI.
Thank you so much, Sunil. I appreciate you coming and talking to me about security today.
Sure, absolutely. Thank you.